Hi, I'm Kevin Harrington, an original shark from the hit TV show Shark Tank. And with me is Noel Randall with Nuurez, Inc. Noel, how you doing?
All right. To see you again.
Hey, thanks for being here.
Thank you.
We got a great crowd and all the good stuff because there's some new things happening in your world.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to say that when it comes to real estate, I know you've been involved in real estate for a number of years, but you've got some new wrinkles we're going to be talking about,
yes,
right?
Yes.
New, and a wrinkle is an option. But I got to go way back because what really blew me away when I first heard that, you know, I know you've had a lot of education, and I found out you went to Penn State.
That's right.
Where my son graduated from,
yes,
at State College in Pennsylvania. So tell me about your educational background, how you kind of got yourself prepared to be able to really do some of these smart investments that you're doing now.
Great question. Thank you. So I have to be honest. I actually was a college dropout at first.
Okay.
So I graduated my bachelor's from the University of Connecticut.
Okay.
And I literally went back to school and finished my degree because I had lost everything in real estate.
Okay.
And I was literally in my parents' basement. Mm-hmm. And they said, if you want to live here with your kids and your husband, you got to go to school or do something.
Right.
So I took my sorry butt back to college and got my first my bachelor's degree, and then ended up, so I'll go back. 04, 05, I'm working, I'm flipping houses, doing that on the side. 07, 08 happens, we lose everything. Just because I really didn't know what I was doing. The market was, you know, awesome.
Right.
Properties,
I know,
are,
a lot of people,
you buy it in the next year.
Well, and then they got hurt. Then they got hurt.
Exactly. Okay. So that was pretty much what I did. So 08, I lose everything. I'm back in my parents' basement. They say, go back to school.
Okay.
And I didn't have much to finish because I had dropped out when I had like 3.5 years. So I go back, finish my degree.
Now, and this is Connecticut.
This is in Connecticut. Okay. So I'm back in Connecticut. And while I'm there in my basement, sorry, feeling like a loser, you know, got some kids and I live in a basement and I'm, you know, bankrupt and all this other
that's
stuff.
It's got to be some pretty grim times.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yep. So I didn't want to lose that real estate. I'd already tried and was flipping houses and I couldn't understand why I couldn't be successful. If
right.
I had gotten those houses, how did I lose them? What did I do wrong? What happened? And so I ended up getting a mentor and a coach, and he taught me wholesaling. You know, and at the time, it was like, whoa, you just find people and they'll sign a contract and you can just flip the contract to someone else. And I mean, it was awesome. So
nice.
I'm working, getting some extra money, get my sorry butt out of their basement.
This is where you don't even have to.
Working, because, you know, that's what you do.
Right.
And go to school, get another degree, because you're climbing the corporate ladder. Oh, you don't have this. Oh, let's go to school. Oh, no, get a certification.
This was the different school now?
Yeah, so now I go to Penn State. Finish my degree. They
nice.
Say get a master's degree. You can't get this. You can't climb the corporate ladder without a master's degree.
Right.
So go to Pennsylvania, get a master's degree.
Okay.
Great. I mean, I love Penn State, don't get
right.
me wrong, but that's what I did it for, just to climb the
and
corporate
go back
ladder.
To school, though. That
exactly.
was a big commitment.
It was a big
cost
commitment.
Cost you money and
it
time,
did.
And you've got kids and, you know, and a business to go build at some
exactly.
point, right?
Exactly. So I get my master's degree in economic development. It's really just to go with the bachelor's degree that I had, because I'm just trying to climb the corporate ladder. And the bottom line to it is I start to realize I'm still doing my real estate deals on the side, but I'm actually making more money and having a little bit more fun doing that than this corporate ladder thing I'm
right.
doing.
That you paid all that educational
exactly.
time and money for,
exactly.
right?
And it's not quite getting that return on investment.
Right.
You know?
Somebody is on top of you every day telling you what
to do,
when to do it, where to be.
Correct.
And the real estate, you kind of do at your own pace.
Correct.
And the market had changed, too. Because after 08, hey, things rebounded a little bit.
It
right?
did. It did.
Exactly.
So 2010, 2011, I started getting some rental properties and kind of doing that whole thing. And then I go, okay, I'm going to do this business thing. So go back to school, right?
Yeah.
Get a business degree. Then I went and get my MBA from Baylor. Now I'm in Texas. So now I have
You did a lot. Wait a minute. Connecticut, Penn State, Baylor. What
yes.
the
I'm just all over the place.
By the way, I'm a college dropout. So I made it a couple of years. I was my junior year of college. And I had to say, I'm going to be an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
So I know the feeling. But I also missed a few things that I could have gotten at college. And fortunately, I was able to bring those people in. But I'm glad to see you did get the education.
I did.
That's powerful.
I did. And I honestly can say, now in this present moment, you know, it has helped a lot. So obviously a few years after I get the MBA or whatever, I'm like, okay, this is not going anywhere. I've gotten every degree, I've gotten every certificate. I'm still just on this corporate treadmill.
Yeah.
And so I start kind of doing the real estate a little bit more, getting more properties, having more fun at work, doing my side business. And eventually I'm like, all right, I figured this thing out. I'm quitting. I'm going to leave work. And I quit corporate America.
And where were you working at that point?
I was working at that point at Pacific Union Financial. So it's a big mortgage company.
Okay.
Big mortgage company.
But you're still in that, you know, kind of money business, so that's good. So that was keeping you on the fringes of your business.
It was. It was. But it was actually holding me back a little bit because you have the job and where do you spend most of your time?
Gotcha. Yeah, absolutely.
And that was what I started to realize. Like the job was getting in the way of really having a true real estate business.
You were working for them, building their dream, not your own dream.
Correct.
Right.
Correct.
Okay.
As you said. So I go ahead, I quit, I'm working, I got my properties, and then I start taking on a few students, you know, telling people what I'm doing, been doing that for a while, start helping lots of people. And that's kind of where I started to come with the idea for Nuurez. Yeah. So as I'm helping students, they're learning wholesaling, fixing and flipping, we're having fun. Some of them are really having a lot of success. You know, I'm having a lot of success with some students, but there's a lot of people I had to kind of leave behind. They don't have the time. They didn't have the money for mentorship. They didn't have, you know, the skill set. They're like, I can't learn that. They're throwing their hands up. Right. I can't learn real estate. Mm. So lo and behold, this idea comes along. And I'll go back a little bit. I have my rental properties. They all have long-term tenants in them. You know, 1 year, 2 year tenants. You know, you got properties. I have this young kid, probably about your son's age, starts telling me about this Airbnb thing.
Mm,
he says to me, let's get some properties, give me a little bit of money. I'll rent some properties, and I bet you they'll make more money than those properties. It's like, really? Kind of cocky young fellow.
Yeah. Hey, start somewhere, okay?
Boy, was he right.
Wow.
And boy, was I wrong.
And this is Nuurez.
And
now,
this is
right?
new. So he gets these properties, he furnishes them. He's making, on one bedroom and studio apartments, he's making $1,500, $2,000
a month. A month in profit.
A month in profit. Whereas I have these long-term rentals, I'm getting $400 profit.
Yeah.
On a good month, you know?
Yeah.
And that's pretty good. You know, you make $400 or $500 a month, you're doing well with a rental property.
Not too bad.
So I was like,
But if you can triple it.
If you can triple it.
Right. Triple the income is better than... Than not, right?
Than not.
I mean, absolutely.
Than not. And so...
basically what this person was doing was leasing an apartment, but then turning around, instead of monthly leasing it out, renting it out nightly or weekly or three or four nights on an Airbnb level, which is now is increasing the gross sales tremendously.
Absolutely.
Because you get a lot more nightly than you can... on a monthly basis.
Absolutely. And it's not as much as you would think. You know, I'm thinking, oh, man, you got to furnish the property. You got to put towels and forks. And I'm thinking this stuff is hard. And it's not hard at all.
Yeah.
It wasn't hard at all.
You'd need a little bit of infrastructure.
Yes.
But not like a whole team of people.
Correct.
I mean, probably like one person could be doing a lot of the stuff that's needed here.
He was running those five properties by himself.
Right.
And then a friend.
And making 3 to 4 times the income off of just regular real estate transactions.
Correct.
Right. I
Correct.
Love it. So this is what Nuurez is all about.
So this is what Nuurez is all about. I start to say, okay, what if we got, and then, you know, we find out about, you've heard about Brian Page, and I know Grant Cardone.
Yeah,
so Grant Cardone's interviewing Brian Page, and he teaches, you know, how to lease the property.
Right.
And so he's really big in that. And mind blown when he said he didn't want to scale it.
Right. I've heard of Brian Page, and so what, did he get too busy with the ones that he had?
He said he just wanted a few, and then he'll teach it to others, and he was making so much money teaching other people how to do it, he wasn't going to scale and get more properties himself.
Okay, so you, I mean, you saw an opportunity at that point, right?
I said, well, if he doesn't want to scale.
Right. Hey, so let me ask you this. The young gentleman, the entrepreneur that brought you in, do you still do business with him, or is he off doing his own thing?
He's doing his own thing, obviously.
Right.
He bought me out, so I loaned him the money to kind of get the properties going. He was just showing me, and then obviously I got my money out. And, you know, we perfected a few things.
You had a short-term relationship.
Yeah.
You learned it. You invested in him, and he's moved on. You now own Nuurez.
Correct.
That's your business.
That is my
business.
So
how many properties have you started with, just getting started?
So we have, I actually had my own properties, you know, obviously, like I said, I had the long-term tenants. So what do? When I find out his, I started kicking my tenants out.
As the leases are expiring,
the leases expire,
I don't need a long-term lease
anymore. I don't need
anymore.
I've got a better idea with this thing.
Now, are these in beautiful neighborhoods, or these are just regular neighborhoods?
Regular neighborhoods.
You don't have to have a house on the beach.
You do not have to have a house on the beach.
This is a house that just is a house or a condo.
Correct.
Right? I mean,
if there's a hotel in the area...
Yeah.
You can have a hotel in that town.
Instead of the hotel, have a larger place and maybe at a similar rate type of thing?
Or, that is correct.
In other words, get double, triple the space for the same amount of money.
That's what
Why
people,
not?
Right. And I
right.
think that's what shocked me is how much of a value it was for other people. I mean, I have 5 kids, so we have been staying in houses because a hotel is super uncomfortable. If you think about it, a husband and wife and 5 kids in one hotel room.
Right. Oh, forget about it.
Right.
Yeah.
Versus a whole house that you get for the same price. So there's been a change in travel. There's
right.
a change in how people vacation. We're yeah. finding people go on vacations together, you know, one husband and wife with another husband and wife, and they go and they vacate. We vacation differently.
Yeah. Well, you know what's interesting is because I never totally understood the whole Airbnb thing in the
yeah.
beginning,
yeah.
but now I've embraced it because I travel a lot.
Yep.
And, you know, recently I was up in Orlando mm-hmm. and we were having a little event.
Yep.
And what, you know, instead of putting 10 people up in individual hotel rooms, which would have been, it was like $300 a night
right.
per person. It was going to be like $3,000 a night for hotel rooms.
Yep.
We were able to get an Airbnb for about $1,000
yes.
that was able to hold all 10 people.
Yes.
And so we saved $2,000 a night, but we had a beautiful place, all everybody in one place. And by the way, instead of 10 individual room services every morning for breakfast and coffee and this and that, we could get a little bit of coffee and a little bit of catering, and we saved, I mean, we probably saved, well, we were saving $2,000 a day on a 3-day event. We probably saved $10,000 when it was all said and done because of the room service and
yep.
the charges and the, by the way, there's resort fees they put
yeah.
on. All of a sudden, it's like, well, wait a minute, you said $300 a night, but it says $380 when I go check out. Well, there's taxes and resort fees
Absolutely.
And this and that. So, I mean, it sounds to me like you've really uncovered an amazing new financial opportunity here.
Really have. And, you nailed it with the convenience. Think about the family, how much money they save when they can go to the grocery store now and go grocery shopping in the
right.
property, even if it's an apartment.
Right.
It's so much more comfortable than a hotel.
Yeah.
They can cook, they can wash clothes, there's a washer and dryer there. The difference from a hotel.
Let me tell you what was interesting, too. So here we got 10 people staying in this one place up in Orlando.
Mm-hmm.
And every morning they were like, oh, we got to clean up. Okay, it's like, I'm like, wait a minute, you guys are being pretty responsible here. What's going on? Well, the agreement that we have to get this beautiful place
right.
is that, you know, they will bring a maid service through,
yep.
but we have certain basics that we have to perform. So,
true.
I mean, they were in tune with really delivering that place back at a quality look. They really were taking care of it.
Yes,
you know?
People and respect that it's yours.
Yeah.
It's not
a
hotel.
Maybe it's a little different than a hotel,
it
right?
It is.
And so so I thought that was pretty cool to see people really wanting to deliver back, the Airbnb in a mint condition kind of situation.
Yes.
Now, of course, they still had to vacuum and clean,
right.
you know, do the laundry and the sheets and the beds and stuff like
right.
that. But it was an amazing thing to see the responsibility that the folks had because they realized what a special opportunity to have. It was a beautiful home that
yeah.
we had rented, right?
Yeah.
And so, so you hope that you get the same kind of attention
mm-hmm.
to detail with your own properties, I'm sure, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Have you had pretty good experiences so
Absolutely.
Far?
Absolutely. I haven't had any. You know, I know there's the horror stories, but I'm going to tell you the awesome thing is, yes, you are correct. Most people, 99% of the population, realizes that it's someone's home.
Right.
You know what I mean? Even if you're doing it as a business, you put some character in there, so they do realize
right.
it's someone's home. And so
right.
most people are very respectable about that. But I'm going to tell you the key, and this is like blew my mind. Say someone comes in there, and they're not respectful. They are crazy.
Right.
And they destroy the property.
Right.
Guess what Airbnb has?
Insurance.
Correct.
There you
Up
go.
To $1 million.
Wow. Hey, that could buy some nice new furniture
it
if
can.
You need it.
Absolutely.
Right?
Okay. Absolutely. Absolutely. And I've actually had some of my guys like, I hope they burn it down. And
yeah. Because you probably got some pretty good videos of what your place looks like now.
Yes.
And what it looks like afterwards.
Right.
So you have proof
yes.
if there's something that happens,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And they maintain and the great thing about it, I'm going to even tell you the benefit from long-term tenant versus short-term tenant. So yes,
yeah.
the money was better. Obviously, if you're renting it out for a month, I think we've done the math and a person pays $1,000 a month or $1,200 a month rent. That comes out to maybe $40 per night. With the Airbnb model, furnishing it and putting it together, you're getting about $140 per night.
Right.
Okay. Now, again, every single night isn't rented. I mean, I've gotten really good, so we do have a pretty high occupancy rate.
Right.
But let's just say on average is 70%. So
okay.
even at 22 nights out of the 30 nights versus right. $140 times right. 22 versus $40 times 30 nights, you right. still are making a big killing.
Yes.
Okay.
Nice. Right. So in terms of now, you, the gentleman that brought you this whole thing to mm-hmm. begin with,
yes.
he was actually spending his own time to manage it all.
Yes.
So that was, he didn't have even an expense for someone to run
right.
his business.
All he
had, was running his business.
And when he first started, he wanted to be, because you charge a cleaning fee, you know that.
Right.
So the cleaning fee is passed to the person that books.
Right.
Okay. And that's another great thing. Because the properties are well maintained, people are there just a few nights. You actually go into the property a lot. So the properties are actually better maintained than some of my long-term tenants, because a lot of time a tenant will have, you know, a broken light or a broken sink. They won't call the landlord.
Yeah.
They're, when I leave, I'll
right.
have them fix it. So by the time you go in there, you're like, hey, what the heck?
You got a few
and you
things.
You got a few, yeah, a few right. things to fix. But when you're going, turning the property so quickly, you're always in there. You say, oh, this is it. Let me fix it. So you keep
right.
the properties up.
Keep it going, right. You know what I just, it just hit me, and this is what you've experienced,
uh-huh.
is in this business model, you're not buying anything. You don't have
right.
to have cash to buy the property. You're leasing.
Yes.
You lease.
Yes.
Now, you don't have to even have staff to do, I mean, you may need a cleaning company.
That's
if,
about
if
it.
You wanna, but you could even do that
you
yourself.
You could even do that yourself. Exactly.
That.
Most people know how to clean.
So you don't have to have any cash.
Nope.
You can lease, and then you start making money literally week number one, because
right.
you're making more money than the lease was, and at the end of month one, you've got a profit.
That
so
is
it's,
correct.
It's pretty powerful.
It starts cash flowing
right.
quickly.
So how many of these can somebody do at one time? Can they do 5, 6, 8, or 10 type
very
of
thing? Easily. Very easily.
And all of a sudden, if you've got that kind of income, you could be making thousands of dollars a month in income.
Correct.
All of a sudden, you got yourself a $30,000-$50,000 a year net income by just taking some of the tips that you're talking about right here, right now.
That is correct.
Yeah.
That's
hey,
correct.
I like it. I think there's a lot of people out there
yeah.
that should be paying attention. Now,
I hope
are you looking for folks that might be listening that for you know to get in touch with you because you're going to show them how to do it? Or
we got a lot of different opportunities.
The
so
way?
There's
what's
a lot interested in doing this and making money with this. They can have their own properties and we can help them, because obviously we have learned some things over the you know the course
yeah.
of doing business. I've learned a few things. Don't put this here.
Right.
Don't say that. Say this. You know, things like
probably
that.
Probably certain kinds of agreements and all of that. I mean, look, if there's anyone out there that wants to make some income, they could just try to go do this themselves. But they're likely to probably run into some obstacles, maybe make a few mistakes,
probably
maybe rent
so.
To the wrong people,
yes.
maybe have the wrong agreements. You've been doing this now almost 10 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think if you're out there and you're listening, you maybe should be, you know, checking this opportunity out, because I even myself, if I were to do this, I wouldn't go try it from scratch myself. I would call you
because you've
done it, and there's probably some kind of rev share deal that you've got.
Absolutely.
Is that what you do?
Absolutely. So we have a revenue share deal, and we have where people, if they want to own hundreds of properties, they literally can buy shares
okay.
into the company and own hundreds of properties without ever going into debt. So we'll
okay.
get into that a little bit later.
Okay.
If that's what people are interested in, I'm sure Bob can kind of give those details, but we really
okay.
just want to open people's eyes that this is a very new opportunity, but it's very profitable.
Right.
Very profitable.
Powerful.
You know, it's
very
powerful.
Good. And so I think, yes, for those that are out there right now, Noelle Randall, she's created an amazing program that shows you how to just go out literally day one. I mean, there are houses for sale, for rent, everywhere in the marketplace, in
Absolutely.
Every community, right?
Yes.
In fact, you could even find somebody that's got one for sale. They
yes.
haven't sold it. It's
Correct.
Been on the market for 3 years. And turn it into an Airbnb.
Ding, ding,
that,
ding.
Right?
Yes.
And then when they sell it, then they don't have to Airbnb it anymore. But
Correct.
In the meantime, they could be getting that extra revenue.
Absolutely.
Right?
We even have deals where people have tried to rent their property. And we're like, you know what? Give it to us for a year. If we find it profitable, we'll buy it.
Right.
If we find that it's not profitable, we'll hand it back. No,
right.
no harm, no foul. We'll lease it for you. We'll guarantee the rent for a year.
Right. Right.
I'm the dream tenant.
Fantastic. Hey. Yeah, because you're not living there, okay? Right?
Right.
And you're going to make sure you're
going
to maintain
And I'm going to make sure. Exactly, because that's what I make money off of.
Right.
So if you give me your property, that's a commodity to me. What am I
right.
going to do? Make sure it's well taken care of
yeah.
and that it's making money.
And by the way, someone that's sitting there that maybe has their own piece of real estate might say, well, hey, maybe I can just do this myself. But again, the first time they do it, they're likely not to do it so well,
right.
make some mistakes,
yeah.
and you know, I would encourage them also, you know, it sounds like you're pretty, you know, giving in your information flow here anyway. So yes. I don't think one deal ain't going to change your lifestyle anyway. So, okay, God bless you if you want to do it yourself. But I still say they should give you a shout.
I would love to talk to them, to get it right.
Of what it's all about.
Exactly.
What all the parameters are. And, yep. I mean, even just something as simple as the right kind of agreement to use.
Correct.
I've got two full-time lawyers in my team, and it's because we need to make sure we got the right kind of agreement.
That is correct.
We've invested money in something. How do we get our money out? That's a big thing. And we've had lots of situations where, you know, without the right agreement, you could be handicapped.
Absolutely.
So I think...
And that was part of what I gave to the young man. Like I said, I kind of knew the business. He was a go-getter. And so that was awesome. But I definitely gave him some, like, let's put some things in place so that this is really profitable.
Right.
And it worked out really well. And we've taken some of the things that we were doing and taken it to a whole nother level. We've learned, we brand our properties a certain way. They look very, you know, they photograph and videograph very well. There's certain things we do with our listings. So we have a couple of tricks and secrets that we do to really get that revenue up.
Right. Well, that's what you guys have learned.
Correct. But we're happy to share because we want people to make the money.
You know, it almost kind of reminds me of like a franchise situation where franchising companies, mm-hmm. they've opened up locations, they figured it out, they got mm-hmm. the ads that work,
yep.
they've got the product that, you know, the cooking preparation, the this, yep. to that, and they teach people how to do it the right way. This is kind of what you're doing
yes.
in a non-franchise real estate fashion.
Right.
And there's... just so many opportunities out there, and I think it's great. So now, you beyond being able to help somebody that wants to do their own thing, and mm-hmm. you can advise them and maybe venture with them,
mm-hmm.
you also have something where people can invest with you too.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
How does that work?
Okay, so the Nuurez opportunity. I have to credit this to one of my business partners who was like, you know, because I wanted it to be. Regular people. Obviously, I've done the mentoring and the coaching, and I've helped many people, and they start their own businesses. But there were quite a few people I felt like I was just leaving behind, you know? Just didn't quite say, oh, I can't commit the time to learning this. I think that was really more of what it is. And so I said, all right, I got all this knowledge and expertise. I know how to get these properties. I know how to get them. I know how to manage them. Let's do this. Put as little as a couple hundred bucks in. Put a few hundred bucks in. We will do all of it.
Yeah.
Show you, and you can literally see it, and then we'll just share the profits with you and be an owner in our company.
Okay, wow.
And be an owner in our company.
Right. Now, is this like a crowdfunding kind
yes.
of thing?
Yes, it is. Oh, so great. We had to go yeah. through a crowdfunding platform to kind of accomplish that.
Right.
Again, I had the idea. I didn't quite know how you pull
yeah.
it off because obviously, you know, in the past, you work with investors. They have to
right.
be accredited. And now, you know, I'm working with doctors and lawyers. And,
right.
you know, they got plenty of money. They don't really necessarily need it. You know, guys like you.
They
like it, but they don't need it. And I was like, I want the ones that really want it.
Okay, good.
You know, I want
yeah.
that guy. I want
work,
that
they're
gal.
They're going to work hard for
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
Right?
But I don't
yeah.
want them to work hard. They
right.
feel, you know,
oh.
I'll do the work.
Okay.
Let me just show you what to do.
Okay,
let me
good.
Just show hey. You what to do. And so that was why we kind of, I had to jump through a few hoops to get it through, you know, the SEC and all this other stuff. But, so we did it through this crowdfunding platform, and people can just put the money in there. We're purchasing properties. We have some agreements already with some pretty large apartment
nice.
Complexes
nice.
That have vacancies.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, literally, Grant Cardone said this.
Mm.
Just throwing that out there. He says it to him, like, wait a minute, I got these big apartment buildings. What if I gave you some of the vacancies? Because there's always vacancies.
Sure, absolutely, yeah.
Brian Page really wasn't interested.
Right.
Well, I was.
Hey, I like it.
Well, I was.
Hey, take advantage of every opportunity.
Exactly,
right?
Yes. Exactly. And then that actually makes it pretty affordable to get them all the same, get all the furniture in there, get all the paint the same, you know, get them all kind of branded and looking the same and know that they're profitable.
Beautiful. So now, are you prepared today to talk about the crowdfunding portal? Or
yes.
Yeah? So
yes.
Tell us where, I mean, what platform is
that? So it
that?
Is True Crowd, TRU. Crowd, T-R-U crowd, C-R-O-D, T-R-U-C-R-O-D. And this is an amazing thing. So this is our launch party.
.com,
yes.
TrueCrowd.com.
TrueCrowd.com. You'll see Nuurez right there.
Right there.
We literally didn't launch it. We wanted to do this big launch and bring in some close friends and things like
yep.
that and kind of celebrate what we were doing. And so we've had this pre-launch, okay? We got like 25 grand in like the first week. Just, we haven't even, no advertising, no, wow. Just...
People coming in.
People coming in. Like, they want to be a part of it. We decided to make the shares super affordable. They're only $1 per share.
Okay.
A dollar per share.
That's why you said invest a couple hundred dollars, get a couple hundred shares.
Correct.
You could invest a couple thousand, get a couple thousand shares.
Correct.
Keep doing the math.
And just keep doing the math.
And then you use the money.
To go get the properties.
Do you buy the properties or do you lease the properties?
So what we're doing with our model, actually, because we were looking at some purchases, but actually looking at the numbers, of course, using my MBA at that point, now I'm like, okay, let's do some numbers. We're really going with the model of lease purchasing
because
we want to make sure they're profitable.
Gotcha.
We're sharing the profits, and we want to make sure we have the most profits for our investors. That was my goal. I want this to be like a no-brainer situation for people to say, okay. And so we actually started partnering with some larger complexes with some vacancies. I was already doing that, but on a smaller, you know, onesie twosies. But now that we have the power of all of these people, we're actually able to negotiate a little bit better too.
I like it. Yeah. Well, I love the concept of a lease option, lease purchase. I mean, I did one of those myself, and I had a 2-year term on the option. The real estate had gone up $500,000 in value, so I exercised the option.
Correct.
And was in the money day
immediately.
One. Immediately. Yes. So if you do the same thing,
correct,
but you're getting cash flow along the way, I mean, what you mean, you're getting the appreciation? If it does,
correct,
then you exercise.
Correct.
And you've made cash along the way. It's a win-win situation. In my mind, one of the smartest moves in real estate today.
Today.
If you can make this happen.
That is correct.
Right. And that's why you're doing it.
That's why we're doing it.
All that schooling, it did pay off. You figured it out, huh?
I finally figured it out.
How about it? I like it. Yes.
Yes.
So now you're gonna. So people are coming in, raising some money to do all of this.
Yes.
What's the goal in terms of the capital raise?
So the first raise, we're going to $1,070,000, and then we're gonna cap it off just for our kind of close circuit people that we've kind of invited and things like that.
Right.
And then we're going to go to our A-plus round because we're going to get some larger complexes and essentially do the same thing. Another thing that we do to make another stream of revenue, our tenants that rent in our property. So say, for example, we have the Airbnb units. We also have the long-term option, okay? So if people want a long-term option in one of our properties, they can exercise the option to put it on Airbnb.
Okay.
Okay, so now we're giving people an opportunity to make income with a property that they rent.
I see.
Gotcha. Okay, and we just take a cut.
Gotcha.
We just take a cut.
Yeah, well, that's a good model. I mean, you're kind of like, you get cuts on all sides.
And our investors do too.
And your investors do too. You share in the results and share in the success.
Yeah.
True Crowd.
TrueCrowd.com. And as little as $500, get you 500 shares, essentially.
500 shares.
Now, again, so that's one model. Remember, we're going to exercise some of those models. So let's give you another great scenario. So we have these lease purchase options, and now we've found that they're profitable. And now, like you said, the appreciation, your example was perfect because we've had that as well, where you exercise the option, and now the property is worth more. We can keep it because it's worth more. Now what can we do? Turn around and sell it.
Right.
And now
so make the profit
make
on the
sale. Profit on the sale.
And the investors would receive their pro rata
that
share based on how many shares they own, et cetera, right? So you've got, do you also, as part of the overall company, do you have an educational program for people where they can buy education?
Yes.
You do have that too.
I do have that too.
Okay.
So if people want
so you
to, you
train
know,
them.
Correct.
You can partner with them. You can let them partner with you. Invest in you, and then you can actually turn back properties to them that they can own in the process. So it's kind of full circle.
A buffet.
Yeah, there you go.
You pick which one. If you want to let us teach it and you do it, I'm okay with that. You want to just put your money in and have us do it, that's fine too. If you want to put your money in and we manage your property and you get to see the profit and we share the, that's okay too. We want everyone to come to the table.
Well, I think because the world is the opportunity. I mean, we're here in the Tampa area, so we got Tampa,
Clearwater,
St. Petersburg, but you got Sarasota, you got Orlando, you know, Florida, Central Florida here, you got Fort Myers, you go down to Naples, you know, you got a lot of areas that within like an hour, give or take, drive.
Correct.
You can be hour and a half, Sarasota down to Naples, down to Fort Myers, and you know, literally 8 or 10 cities. Mm-hmm. So you have opportunities to help people invest in projects with you, learn, but also end up you know, cashing out and owning some of these themselves.
Absolutely.
At the same time.
Yes.
So,
and we got a lot in Orlando now, obviously, with the parks, Disney World, right. SeaWorld. So that's been a great market for me personally.
Right.
When I was coming to, people were like, oh, can I buy in into your property? So one of the reasons why we started Nuurez is so that these are our properties.
Right.
Not Noel trying to create agreements. So
gotcha.
People, you get what I mean? And that
right.
was getting a little messy.
Okay.
So we were like, let's just make these our properties.
Okay. And this is all the entity that is this is a, this
Nuurez.
Is an equity
Correct.
Crowdfunding
yes.
on a truecrowd.com. So there's a lot of opportunities out there. So
yes.
we're for folks that are interested in getting in touch with you, mm-hmm. don't necessarily want to send them. I mean, they could see what's happening at TrueCrowd.
Yes, they can go to. Yep.
They should really talk to you first. So where is that? What's the best place to track Noel down?
So actually, there's two places. You can go to noelrandall.com. Obviously, all of my contact information is there.
And
kind of what
N-O-E-L.
We're doing. Sorry, N-O-E-L-L-E.
L-L-E.
Mm-hmm. Randall, R-A-N-D-A-L-L.
Two L's.
Two
right?
L's.
Dot com.
Dot com.
Got it.
And then we have Nuurez, N-U-U-R-E-Z.com.
N-U-U-R-E-Z.com. So
Correct.
Either your personal site or the corporate site, which the Nuurez.com, will that tell them about the equity
Absolutely.
Crowdfunding?
Absolutely, that'll tell
that
them
point.
About the equity crowdfunding. Our investors already are able to post properties.
Right.
There's a section where you can post properties, and we even have, and this is amazing because I have to get this out, a door bounty. Because
okay.
we're interested in monetizing and in compensating people for everything that they do. And obviously, we have a big undertaking. We want a lot of properties. I got some people
right.
I'm trying to catch.
Yes.
All right?
Yeah.
And I want them to bring us properties, and I'm glad to pay them for that. So
right.
we have even a door bounty if they know of someone.
Right.
Okay? If our investors know of someone
yeah.
and we can get those properties, we'll pay
right.
them.
You know, I remember I've been in the As Seen on TV space yeah. for close to 40 years. In the early days, some of these guys would come out and talk about buying real estate with no money down.
Right.
But you still, you know, they showed you how to do it without money, but you still had to buy it, own it, and
yeah.
you took a little bit of risk
you
because
did.
What happens if you can't resell it for more?
Right.
Or you got to pay a commission to somebody to sell
right.
it. Here, you're doing this with no money down, but you're just leasing.
Yeah.
You don't have to buy. You're hedging it to where you can buy only if the lease made sense.
Only if
so
it's profitable.
So this is come in with no money. You're going to teach people how to turn properties into cash flow machines and then have the opportunity to buy them if and only if it makes sense.
Correct.
That's an amazing way to structure a business relationship. And by the way, I mean, anybody that is interested in this, they should check out both sites.
Yeah, really the Nuurez.
Yeah.
Nuurez.com has pretty much all of the information.
Right.
You can invest there. Investors can post their properties there. You can see what we're doing. You can see the crowd, the number. Like I said, the sheer number of people that we have no advertising, no, just telling people, a few people we know.
Well, it's amazing
what to do.
Just in the brief interviews that we're doing here, that I can really get a sense that you truly are there to help people. That
yeah.
you want to, you know, I don't think if somebody just came to you and said, you know, can I just get some education? I'm going to go do it. That you'd be fine with that because, you know what? You probably figure at some point they may come back looking for some help anyway,
right?
Because it's not so easy.
Right.
I mean,
we figured a few things out.
You've got
out,
10 years under your belt doing
yeah.
this. For someone that's just starting out, I'm going to recommend that they track you down,
yeah.
get a hold of your systems, partner with you in some fashion.
Yes.
And then, hey, if they want to go out on their own, God bless, let them go do it. But
right.
in the meantime, you're building your business, the equity crowdfunding, and it's an amazing concept. I think you've done a great job. And just last thing, let's send them to Nuurez, Nuurez.com,
yes.
or Noel. Randall.com, NoelleRandall.com. One of those two sites, they're going to find some great stuff.
Yes, they will.
Hey, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
It's Kevin, the original shark from Shark Tank, telling you, check out one of those two sites. Please do it. Take care. Thank you.